We're going to dive into the Tubebuddy extension for Chrome and how to grow with it on YouTube this year. I'm going to give you a complete breakdown of how I use Tubebuddy. We'll also go over exactly how to find it, how to add it to Chrome. It's very simple. And in a few minutes, I'm going to share my screen and we're going to go over all of this step by step and then also give you some tips on how I use Tubebuddy to grow my channel. I'm going to give you a complete breakdown over this, how to install it, where to find it, how to get it installed to Google Chrome, the pricing, all of that good stuff, and more importantly, how this extension has helped me grow my channel. I will leave a link to Tubebuddy down below. I am an affiliate to it, so if you do purchase through my link, I will make a small percentage off that if you do purchase through my link. I just want to let you know that. You don't have to purchase through my link, but I do appreciate it. It's what helps this channel go and make more and more tutorials like this. So if you do want to purchase through my link, it's down below, and I do appreciate that. So in about 1 minute, I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to show you exactly how to find Tubebuddy, add it as an extension to your Chrome browser, and then be able to actually use it to help you grow, some of the tips on how I actually use it, and then also some of the key features. This is a perfect tool for a beginner or someone who actually is an established YouTuber who's looking for an edge, who's looking to grow quicker, and is looking to be able to produce content consistently that gets found in the search engines. So before we jump into it and I share my screen, I am James Cook. If you're new to my channel, I create business tutorials. I talk about online business investing from experience and personal development. So if you like that type of content, definitely click the subscribe button now and the bell icon so you don't miss any of my weekly videos. I always try to deliver a lot of value in the videos. Now let's hop on over to my screen and get right into it. Okay, so the first thing you wanna do to install Tubebuddy, go over to Google, type in Tubebuddy. So type in Tubebuddy, and you see its website right here. Click on the website. Up to the right, you wanna click sign in right here. All right, so we're gonna click that. Then you wanna sign in with Google. You wanna use your Gmail, okay? So this is the first step. I will use one of my other accounts. Now once you're in here, what you want to do is add your channel right here. We're going to hit add channel. Again, I'm picking the Gmail. You would be picking yours. You want to install Tubebuddy, and then you also want to click once it comes to here. Tubebuddy wants to access your Google account. You have to allow them, so we're going to click allow. Now, this is a licensed starter pack. The starter pack is actually free. You don't pay for this at all. If you're just starting off, you could leave this for now and always upgrade later. I'm going to jump into my account. You're going to see that I have a paid account. If you wanted to upgrade, this is what the accounts look like. I have the Pro, which is $9 a month. But if you have less than 1,000 subscribers, it will only be $4.50. Just make sure you check that off. And then obviously once you go over 1,000 subscribers, it will automatically go back to $9 a month. Some people do use these other bigger plans. For me, I just stick with the Pro, and I'll show you how I use the Pro, but I just want to show you that you can actually start with the starter account, which is free. Then if you have less than 1,000 subscribers and you wanted to do the Pro plan and have some of the extra benefits, you can just click this off and get it for $4.50 a month. Well worth it. But again, if you're just looking for the starter one, that's for free. Now I will jump into my account real quick so you can just see what that looks like. Okay, so I showed you the other account because I wanted to show you what it would look like when you first sign up with Gmail into Tubebuddy. And now your account is set up. Now you see I do have the Pro account. I'm paying $9 per month. So the next thing you want to do is go back over to Google once you have this account set up. And this time when you type in Tubebuddy Chrome, and then you're going to see this chrome.google.com. Come over to here and you're going to see add to Chrome. Now we want to add to Chrome, add extension. Okay, so now you'll see this. This is verifying Tubebuddy has been added to Chrome. Once you come over to Tubebuddy.com after you install the extension, you're going to see you have successfully installed the Tubebuddy extension. Now I'm going to go click on my account. And we're back in this window where it shows me all the details on my account. But now that the Chrome extension is installed, what I can actually start doing is head over onto YouTube. And up here, right here, you see it says Tubebuddy sign in required. Click here. I'm going to click on that, and we just want to make sure that we're signing in. Click that you have agreed, sign in with YouTube. You want to pick the account that you're using. Mine would be my Gmail. Again, we're going to allow it. Remember, we need to allow it. And then you'll see up here, successfully signed in. Now we can use TubeBuddy. So now I know a lot of people that talk about TubeBuddy stop here about installing it. I want to dive a little deeper and show you exactly how I use it to optimize my videos better and get the best results when it comes to growing on YouTube. So right now I'm in YouTube. You see that I successfully signed in. Here is actually the TubeBuddy dropdown. If you click this little icon, you'll see some of the features. You could check out milestones, which shows you where you are as far as subscribers and gives you little badges and stuff. That's really not the important stuff though. One of the biggest important things that I use inside here is Keyword Explorer. So right over here, you see Keyword Explorer. We're gonna click on Keyword Explorer. I'm going to show you how I actually use this. The whole idea for this to help you grow is to find titles that you can title your YouTube videos that will help you get found, help traffic get to your videos. And another word for this is search engine optimization or SEO, which I talk about a lot. And TubeBuddy actually helps you optimize and find the low-hanging fruit when it comes to the right keywords for you to talk about. Now, for an example, I had a video that did really well, which was how to create a Facebook group or some type of title like that in 2020. First, when I first thought of the ideas, how to start a Facebook group, you know, I've started many Facebook groups before and helped other people start them. So I knew that people were looking for that and searching for that. So I knew that I can help them with an answer, because that's the other thing. Not only do you need to know about the topic you're going to talk about when you're optimized for it, but you want to really give a good answer. So when I typed in how to start a Facebook group, I noticed that it was poor. And really what's cool about this Keyword Explorer is it's showing me and rating how I would actually do if I went for this keyword. Now here's some tips. For search volume, we want it to be as high as we can up towards the green. That means a lot of people are actually typing this in and searching for an answer. Now, when it comes to competition, we want to also make sure that that's as high into the green. If you see that it's in the red and poor, it's pretty much saying that we really don't have a chance of being found for this term. Now, optimization strength, we want it to also be in the green. This is just saying that not too many people are optimized fully for that term. So the further in the green, the better. And then I also like to see right down here, number of monthly searches, and it's an estimate. It's always a great sign to see that people are actually searching this per month. So those are great signs. The one thing that makes me stay away though is that the competition is just too hard. So we're not going to go for this term. But you'll notice over here, they also give you some suggested terms, how to start a Facebook group for your business. So let's just click on that and see how it goes. Okay, so not as high search volume, a little bit less competition, overall optimization strength still in the green, still has a okay amount of monthly searches, not as good as the other term. So you know what, this is a little better, but I wanna see if I could get the competition even higher into the green. So what we're gonna do now, you see how there's no related search terms around this? What I'm actually going to do is try to reword this a little bit. Maybe instead of how to start a Facebook group, I'll put how to create a Facebook group. How to create a Facebook group. Let's see how this goes. All right, so excellent search volume, excellent optimization strength. Now we're in the yellow, so we're getting closer. The only thing I don't like is that it's not showing me monthly searches, but because this is so high in the green, I'm not too worried about that. This is an excellent sign that it's saying that this has search volume. So this exact keyword was how to create a Facebook group for your business. So this is a pretty good term. This is probably something that I can go for, especially because I talked about this before and my video did very well. So this topic would probably do well for me as well. Another thing I can actually do is also explore even further. And here's another tip that I like to do. I'll take this couple words off at the bottom of this sentence. So instead of for your business, I'm just gonna delete that. So now we have how to create a Facebook group. And as soon as I hit space, you'll notice it automatically has all these drop downs that are giving me suggested things that people type in. So I could do how to create a Facebook group on mobile. Let's click on that. Okay, so search volume less, towards the red.
Not really loving this. So what will I do again? I'll delete this. Remember, we already found the one for your business, which was good. So I'll save that idea, but I just want to come back in. Now that we know that how to create a Facebook group is our main target, now I just want to see what else is in here. So we have how to create a Facebook group for affiliate marketing. Let's check that out. Okay, so this is a great sign. This is showing that the competition, I'm all the way in the green, so I found something that's not so competitive. It has okay search volume. It's not in the green. The whole idea here is, though, if we could get everything in the green and their search volume, you have a really great chance of winning for that keyword term for when someone searches for that, they'll see your video. And if you have other things in place, like an optimized thumbnail, you have your tags optimized, and I go over this other stuff in other videos, which I left in the description, where I go in more depth of how to optimize your videos when you create your channel, how to optimize your channel, how to find the right keywords, how I explore, and I go dig even deeper with TubeBuddy and Keyword Explorer. I would definitely go check that other video out so that you can understand, once you have it installed and you're going through this process, exactly what else I look for to find those winning terms that I know can optimize my videos for and generate targeted traffic. So the bigger authority channels can go after the more competitive terms. If you're just starting off and you don't have a big authority channel and you have only a few subscribers or even only a few thousand subscribers, you want to find these low-hanging fruit terms so that you can start winning, get more subscribers, get more views, and start building momentum. As your channel builds and you are talking about a specific topic and niche and becoming an authority figure, that's when you can start going after the more competitive terms. I just want to give you another example, just like this video you're watching now, which is a tutorial on TubeBuddy. So if I just typed in TubeBuddy tutorial, you're gonna notice that everything is poor, right? It's showing me that this is poor. Okay, I know some people are searching this in. Look, 280 people a month, it's saying, so that's still okay. I would love to win that, but it's saying that the competition's just too high. So, and they're probably right. Like, the competition is probably high because TubeBuddy tutorial. So I start going through everything that I was teaching you, maybe TubeBuddy tutorial for 2020, which is now 2021. So I would want to go for a TubeBuddy tutorial 2021. But I know if TubeBuddy tutorial 2020 got some searches, then most likely TubeBuddy tutorial 2021 would. And then I started exploring more, and then I start thinking also, what did I start doing? How do I use TubeBuddy? And then I think, oh, I use the Chrome extension. So then I'll start going, okay, TubeBuddy Chrome extension. And I'll start testing out this word and see how it is. Okay, now this is saying that it's very good competition. Okay, so I like this. So this is the exact process of how I actually made this video for you guys to view right now. If you found my video by typing in some type of keyword around TubeBuddy Chrome extension, or you suggested this video by typing in other terms and watching other videos similar, it's because I actually optimized this video after I did enough research using TubeBuddy to find the right term that I can actually pop up for. And by doing it this way, I was able to find that people are actually searching and trying to learn how to install TubeBuddy and get the Chrome extension and also use it the way that I use it. So not only do I know about this, but I can teach this and show you quickly, just like I'm doing now, how to sign up for TubeBuddy, how to install it, some of the pricing and the features, and then these tips inside of TubeBuddy, especially with Keyword Explorer, on how to actually use this to find terms like I just showed you so that you can actually win on terms that are getting searched and start building and growing your YouTube channel and getting traffic to your YouTube videos. So you're signing up for TubeBuddy, you're going and finding the Chrome extension link, you're adding it to your Chrome extension, you're gonna sign in through YouTube as well, allow them to access all the data. So that is quickly how to install TubeBuddy, get it onto your Google Chrome extension, and start utilizing it to help you. Now, I do have more in-depth videos down below, so check them out if you want to learn a little bit more on how I'm finding the right keywords, but I just wanted to show you some of the key features, the pricing. You can actually start just a free account. If you upgrade, you will get some benefits and some perks that the free account does not have, but this is how we're using it. Keyword Explorer is probably one of the best features. This is how I'm using it. Hope you got a lot of value out of this.
I hope you see the power of TubeBuddy and how this really gives you the edge, even at the lowest plan possible, and how I'm using it to cipher some words and get that little advantage. And it really is a great tool. I also made another video on how to start a YouTube channel in 2021, 10 simple steps, with a nice free guide. If you want to watch that, I'll leave that up here and a link down below in the description. I highly recommend you check that out. It's a very simple step-by-step guide that I break down important steps that if you're committed to, I can almost guarantee you that you're going to grow in time on YouTube. I'll leave the link to TubeBuddy and the link to that video down below in the description as well. If you do like this video and you found some value, please hit that like button. It does help me with the YouTube algorithm and I do appreciate it. Definitely subscribe if you like this type of content and you want to learn more, and I will see you in the next video.